Copenhagen Wolves. Earlier today, the Supa crew managed to get their hands on Yasuo once again, and Selfie proved just why it has been banned against him so often. It was a close game throughout, but once they landed the Wombo combo, it was game over for Millennium.
It was, and it was just a very, very nice performance by Selfie, constantly kiting Millennium around on the map, baited them into bad situations, and Supa crew managed to punish Millennium and also actually win the game. They have had some issues in this Super Week, but they look better here in the last game, we have to say it. I still have a very hard time actually predicting how strong Supa crew will be when we look into the quarterfinals, because it's been ups and downs, inconsistent performance. They do have the players, they do have the talent, but it's just, we don't see it often enough where they perform.
Yeah, it's not been a great Super Week for them so far. Only got the one win, of course. On the flip side, the Copenhagen Wolves, well, they only have one win themselves so far in Super, and will need another to avoid a tiebreaker with Gambit. They are currently tied in seventh place with. Of course, if they lose this match, they will be playing against Gambit once again, and that's going to be happening tonight. But I should also point out that if the Copenhagen Wolves win, then SK and Supa Hot Crew have a tiebreaker. Exactly. So we've got a tiebreaker, whatever happens now tonight.
But only one game. So
only the one game, as opposed to what Joe said, talking about multiple games.
Only one game here. And Copenhagen Wolves yesterday, good performance against Rocket, where they actually dominated the game. They won early mid-game, they won the right team fights. Vulite got very far ahead on Tristana, so he could just carry the game by himself. I mean, 8-0-2 on a hyper carry. And the game wasn't even that long, so pretty impressive performance from him. And we just see Copenhagen Wolves always stick to the same aggressive playstyle, which worked yesterday, but we have also seen a lot of games where it backfires and the other team win an important team fight and Copenhagen Wolves just fall too far behind.
Well, while the Copenhagen Wolves may not have a shot at the playoffs, the Supa crew doesn't want to underestimate their shot caller, Broken Shard.
Speed coming Wolves is mostly just about controlling the lanes pretty much, because we should be able to outclass every lane. Because we have better players.
Mechanically, they have some really good players. I rate Mimer as very, very, very highly as a top laner.
I still train and talk to Mimer a lot, but lately we haven't been training together as much as we wanted to.
Honestly, I haven't even watched the Wolves games. Like, they have nothing to play for, except pride.
I believe Broken Shard, he's definitely a very decisive jungler. He knows how to make calls, especially in very tense moments. Like, he knows when exactly to do dragon and when to do an objective.
I kind of feel that they have no definite shot caller on their team. They kind of have a lot of different ideas and ways to approach the game. I think that their players are really, really prone to tilting. So if we get early objectives and focus a lot in the early game, I think we could easily get the upper hand on them.
Copenhagen was actually still a force to be reckoned with, so I wouldn't take them lightly.
We'll see whether either of them are focusing on the right targets, of course. Let's check out the lineups for these two teams. Over on the blue side, starting out is the Supa Hot crew. That means Mimer's in the top lane, Impaler's on the jungle, Selfie in the mid lane, Mr. Rala's at AD carry, and Kasing on support.
And on the red side, we do have Copenhagen Wolves with Youngbug in the top lane, Broken Shard in the jungle, Soren in the mid lane, Vulad as the AD carry, and Unlimited on support.
So let's check in over on lolesports.com, see who you guys think has the edge in this one. It's a big vote, ladies and gentlemen. 80% for the Supa Hot crew.
Huh, so even though they lost two games already this Super Week, they're very, very shaky. People still believe they can beat the Wolves. I mean, yeah, they are the favorites, but they're definitely not by 80%.
The Supa Hot fans, I think they're
super
sort of
hot fans
calling themselves out. There's a lot of them out there. They're starting definitely growing that fan base. So pick and ban's getting underway. What are we expecting? Pretty sure Yasuo is not going to sneak through for Selfie this time.
No, should be a ban against Supa Hot crew. Orianna should be a ban against Soren. He's played it twice already and really been performing well. So should be a ban at least. Some teams, for some reason, leave it open. He always picks it and does really well. And otherwise, we can look at Maokai, Gragas, all these picks here. Top lane Gragas is a Mimer pick at the moment. Youngbug only played it once or twice, I believe. And it's been okay for him. But generally, his performance on other champions has been somewhat the same. So I don't feel like you have to target towards Youngbug.
Do you think they're going to be fighting over Brown maybe? Of course, Kasing and Unlimited both like to play that champion. I think it's Unlimited most played champion.
It is, yeah. Yeah, so definitely been the top pick for him. He loves to roam around, but generally, we don't see teams target Unlimited either. It's like you want to go for the jungler or you want to go for Soren in the mid lane, normally against Copenhagen Wolves, and I expect Supa crew to do the same.
Well, let's see how it works out, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to get underway. This is game 4 of the day. There will be 6 games today, no matter what happens now. And and this is going to be the start to decide who will be that final tiebreaker match. Lee Sin banned out, taking that away from Broken Shard, who did play that earlier on in the day. Kassadin, there we go. That's not going to sneak through this time around. Is going to get banned out by the Wolves.
Okay, so Braum actually being banned by Subaku, you were correct before. Target towards Unlimited, played it 9 games already. Clearly his best support, but not often we see it actually banned away against the Wolves.
See if Orianna's going to get banned here. Yasuo has been taken away from Selfie. Orianna is banned, sure enough, away from Solomon.
Sort of standard ban.
Gragas first pick potentially here. It's Youngbuck's best champion. Haven't seen Mima doing too great on it. He's more of a big Shyvana player. Will it be picked or banned?
The funny thing is, both these top laners, the most played champion is actually Shyvana, but she's fallen out of favor a little bit, except for Mima, who still picks her up very often. Youngbuck, we've seen Dr. Mundo a lot lately from him. Could pick it into Shyvana if Superhardcore wants to play it, but Rengar is open. Impaler is apparently known for as the best jungle Rengar in Europe. Not that we have too much competition at the moment. And Mima, of course, loves to play Rengar in the top lane in solo queue.
Remember, of course, they talked about having some sneaky tactics. We'll see whether this is sneaky enough or whether they are saving it for the quarterfinals next week.
Did you just say sneaky on purpose?
Maybe.
Okay, so Morgana here, Subaru played it earlier. Been actually one of the main picks for Kasing, and they love to do Morgana Tristana because you now provide the Black Shield to your late game hyper carry. It's a decent lane, you have some good poke, you even have all in potential, and then late game it just becomes so hard to deal with this hyper carry. So, standard support pick at least for Kasing.
Talking about AD carriers, you know, Mr. Rollins and Walleye both pretty much the stars of their teams, I guess you could say. Although Mr. Rollins had a bit of a quiet summer, that's for sure. Warlight, though, he can play any AD carry that gets thrown at him, and he usually performs very well on it.
Yeah, it's actually pretty weird. He's played 8 AD carries already, which is the most of all here in Europe. And we have seen Ashe from him, Jinx has been picked up, a lot of different AD carries. Lately, he's preferred the likes of, you know, Tristana as well, actually, for him, or maybe a Corki pick could come in. Not a Teemo.
Not going to be a Teemo locked in, that's for sure. That'd be an interesting one. Ziggs, though, picked for Sorin in that mid lane. So going with the mid lane champion early on, that, of course, gives Selfie an option of Ahri. Don't forget, he played that very, very well last week. Elise will get locked in for Broken Shard. Ahri immediately considered for Selfie.
Standard enough here, Elise. Still one of the top junglers, and they really want to put Sorin on a champion where he can actually win the laning phase and then impact the map afterwards. Which is also one of the reasons he loves to play Orianna. And he brings so much lovely wave clear to the table here, but super hard group. Definitely not going to be Katarina. Could be the Ahri pick for Selfie, but they don't actually have to pick it early on here. But there's still a lot of options. The jungler is open, Lissin is banned, Elise is picked. Just take the Rengar.
Just take the damn Rengar. Remember, we are Cogmore probably going to come in for Mr. Rallis. Is it going to be selected? Cats once again in Flick 2. Of course, Impaler's played Jarvan a number of times. It is going to be the Cogmore for Mr. Rallis, so no surprises there. I think we're going to see Ahri for Super Arc Career here. I wonder what the Wolves are going to do to counter.
And it is a very, very slow champion select so far. Both teams really thinking over the picks here and taking their time. Even the first pick, Morgana, almost down to like 5 seconds before it was locked in by Super Hawkroon. We've seen Impaler on Jarvan. Very mixed results. Good games, terrible games. So one of these are inconsistent picks, and it would work with an Ahri to catch people out of position from Copenhagen Wolves. However, the Ziggs would be able to just satchel charge out. For now, however, very standard picks. No special tactic yet.
Well, I mean, there's a lot on the line for these teams, and honestly, with the quarterfinals looming, they don't want to give too much away. If there is any sneaky tactics out there.
I also say sneaky.
You can now. Well done. Our voice coach is doing wonders for you, buddy.
Thank you. I'm glad you're proud of me.
I am very proud of you. You work hard at this. So, Tristana and Thresh locked in. That's a strong bottom lane pairing for Copenhagen Wolves and the Super Hawk crew. We'll see how that works out between the two of them. At the moment, that Nami is, well, we did just see a top Morgana. You never know.
Yeah,
you never know, but I'm pretty sure that's not going to happen.
No, I don't expect Selfie to play a lot of Morgana mid lane. However, he could still surprise. But Super Arc Crew, I actually heard them talk on their way down to the stage, and they were saying they really want to win this game here. They want to avoid having to go in and play a tiebreaker against SK Gaming, so they want to go in here, win the game, and just that's it. Focus now on quarterfinals, where the Copenhagen Wolves, of course, the same deal. You don't want to end this situation where you have to play Gambit. Now, if you lose, you get last spot in the LCS and no choice of who you're going to face in the challenge or in the promotion tournament.
Well, at the moment, of course, Super Hot Crew, if they were to win this game, they would be playing Rocket in the quarterfinals. Otherwise, it will be a tiebreaker with SK to see who they're going to be facing. Ahri is locked in, and Shyvana in that top lane. So standard champions in forms of Super Hot Crew. This is what we've seen them playing a number of times. It works well. It is a good combo for them. We'll see whether the Wolves have anything else tucked up their sleeve for the jungle, for the top lane.
For the top lane here. Dr. Mundo again has been the pick for Youngbok in the last few games.
It's not been great.
No, it's not been the best pick for him, but it works against the Shyvana, because sure, you have some issues early, but you will become so tanky she can't deal with you in the late game points. She's good in mid game against him with a blade, but as long as he survives till the late game, he will become this monster tank. Ahri seems to be the option, which he did play in London against Alliance, where he had this fantastic game, picked up 12 kills, I believe, yeah. And we were praising him, saying this is probably the best Aurelia performance we have seen all split.
Yeah, they was pretty much carrying the Wolves throughout that game. But the final switch is going to be back to his old tried and tested champion that he played pretty much for around about two seasons in the championship. You have Rengar in the top lane, Renekton, sorry, in the top lane.
So a lot of focus here from Copenhagen Wolves on winning the solo lanes. Actually winning all the lanes. Tristana is a very strong lane as well here. So good lanes from Copenhagen Wolves. One of them use the mid game power of Renekton and Ziggs to try and bully out Super Crew. Do have the issue, however, that Tristana is fairly weak in the mid game and gonna have to get some time before she gets strong in the late game points. But you have Renekton, you have Ziggs, you have a lot of options here to get past the mid game and into the late game.
Well, we'll see how this one works out, ladies and gentlemen. If you think one team has the advantage after Champ Select, tweet us at LOL Esports using the hashtag SHCWin for the Super Hot Crew and CWWin for the Copenhagen Wolves. We'll check in your responses during the game. So, about to get things underway. Big, big match. Super Hot Crew could finish third. This is a big, big thing.
Yeah.
To finish third in the season in your only the second split in the LCS is a pretty big deal for a team that basically qualified one day before the LCS began back in the spring.
And they did have some changes on support. Also Selfie coming in for the mid lane instead of Moops earlier, or last split, sorry. So there were some changes, they had to get the synergy going, but they have been playing as a strong team. We keep talking about this potential they have, they're almost a new CLG in that case. But they're just way too inconsistent. You never know what to expect, especially from Selfie in the mid lane. It's either 10-0 or 0-10.
Yeah.
There's no in between.
It seems that if he gets a champion that he enjoys and knows exactly how to play, it works out well for him. We saw that once again with Yasuo. He was so fluid in his play on that champion. But then when you get him a champion that can go all in and really has no way out, it can be disaster time, as we saw before as well. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Game four underway. Super Hot Crew facing the Copenhagen Wolves. The winner will decide who will be facing. The tiebreakers will know at the end of this match.
Let's see. Up in his top lane, Mimer, Cloth Armor, and Potions. So looks like Super Hot Crew wants to actually do standard lanes and just try and outplay Copenhagen Wolves, even though there are some very strong lanes from the side of Copenhagen Wolves. And we've seen the tactic before where the Wolves, they aim to win laning phase, get the very first dragon of the game, get a goal lead, and then try and snowball the game and finish it fairly fast, actually. Not really looking to go full late game when we see Copenhagen Wolves play. Last put, different story, however, from Copenhagen Wolves.
Mime is about to find Youngbok. As soon as he comes around the corner, he's going to get a bit of a trade with him. Impaler's coming up. Oh, he's going to get a skittering spider from Broken Shard instead, so he will not chase on towards him. And that's just simple ward placement. Good ward placement for Copenhagen Wolves, of course, on that red. It does mean they have full vision as we get a pause.
And we get a pause here. Mimer with some issues.
I wonder if he couldn't use his skill, because it looked like he was trying to use the Q and didn't actually land it in that fight. So I wonder if it just didn't level up or something. That's what I'm personally thinking anyway.
Could also be the standard rune page. which we have seen a few times where
well
played Lulu in the last game or whatever AP champion and can't really swap.
If you you'd know that by now. Before the game load, he'd be like, I can't switch it. Yeah, I hope you weren't into the game.
Maybe he didn't notice.
Maybe he did a hotshot GG and just like, I don't need runes at masteries. I'm just going to play without them.
It was good stuff. We actually sat in the office and watched the very first NALCS game where hotshot forgot to select his runes.
Way back when. It is just going to be a quick restart of the game client for Mima, so they'll be sorting that out in just a moment. And
apparently, Renekton's HP bar is bugged, according to Mimo here.
Has he got health?
I'm not too sure.
Is that the bug? He's like, guys, I hit him and it didn't show any damage. Who knows? Mimo's going to sort that out. So he'll be back in the game in a moment. So what do we think overall between these two teams? A lot of pressure on both of them. Copenhagen Wolves, I was sat upstairs with them as they were watching that game along with SK support crew. They were just like, everyone in this room wants us to lose. Because they want us to play Gambit.
Yeah. I mean, it would be a very exciting game against Gambit, especially because Gambit now have come back in Super Week, won so many games. Still, for Copenhagen Wolves, you really want to avoid this tiebreaker game because just get your number 7 spot so you can choose whoever you want to face in the promotion tournament, and that's it. No reason to play an extra game if you are the Copenhagen Wolves.
Well, as it stands right now, before anyone wins this match, it will be Super Hot Crew facing a tiebreaker because the result of this match actually happens to matter quite a lot. It will be Millennium in there, Rock Hatter in there, SK Gaming. So SK Gaming up against Millennium is most likely, who knows, we'll see how it works out for them. This game, of course, will be the big decider. If Super Crew do win it, they will finish outright third place with 16 wins. And that would leave SK Gaming to face Millennium in the fourth and fifth. Remember, all this is happening. The quarterfinals, they will be played out next Thursday and Friday, right here, best of five in the studios, along with, of course, the challenger matches that will be happening, their best of fives as well. But right now, we have Mima going, I can't see a hit bar, mate. It's not happening.
You don't need it.
I'm not
just
sure
farm
if
minions,
he's,
man. Just
I'm not sure if
minions.
Mime is quite Danish. His Danish goes in that exact accent, but
I never heard him speak Danish. Sadly.
No.
No, he's Swedish.
I know he's Swedish. But I never know when he's gonna go Hodor.
Swedes don't speak Danish. It's a very different language.
You guys generally learn each other's languages fairly well.
No, they have a terrible accent. I can't understand it honestly.
I'm pretty sure the Swedish say you guys have a worse accent. And I would actually agree.
Okay. Well, so Danish people...
I know there's a lot of Danish in the crowd
There is
today,
in the crowd.
Actually. Yeah, there is.
We just have a very beautiful accent. A very special one. And if you can speak it, you sound like a gentleman who mumbles.
People have read it. Do you believe Danish accent is beautiful?
It is. It is. Like pulse.
These guys at the front, they believe they have a beautiful accent.
Look at the Danish people.
They've got the flags and everything. Honestly, you know, I have to give credit to the Danish fans because every single week we do have a lot of Danish fans here.
Yes.
That is for sure.
And they're always very loud. They have some flags with them and really make sure people notice the 5.2 million Danish people in the world, and we want to show it to everyone.
You represent yourself well, that's for sure. Especially in League of Legends pro scene, you represent yourself very well. Way better than England, that's for sure. Speaking of England, there's Impaler. He's next to them.
Yes.
Alongside a good Danish man in the middle, again. And a Danish guy in AD carry. But there's an English guy in support. It's actually a pretty well split support crew.
Two English people, you have a Dane. A Polish person in the middle, not a Danish
A Polish one. Guy. Sophie is Polish. Yeah. I'm thinking Soren on the other side.
Yeah. Well, we have enough Danes, at least.
Enough about Denmark.
Denmark.
I know you love Denmark.
It is Lee Epic.
Copenhagen Wolves are playing, after all. So
they are.
It seems we are going to have another client restart. Although mine is typing like a fury right now.
I don't think he's typing. He's only hitting like 4 buttons.
Yeah, he's testing skills out. Or maybe it's just like doing world domination while he sat there. I don't know, the look on his face, it looked like he was. Pretty intense.
Let's see. Always,
how many referees does it take to restart a client?
Clearly a lot here. Taco Storm in the background looks very worried, actually.
He looks intent, doesn't he?
Yes. Oh, what's going on?
There's a Borson in there as well now. It's serious.
And our new referee.
Yes, yes, the new guy in the background. Piotr. I think I didn't butcher his name there.
Could also just say Peter.
We could, if you really just want to ruin his name. But let's talk about the current situation.
I know tiebreaker.
We're talking about tiebreakers. Who will come out on top? And more importantly, who does Super Hot Crew want to face? Because it's in their hands. They can either face Rocket, or they go head-to-head with CSK Gaming, who have looked very good this weekend, and potentially face Millennium.
Yeah, so if we do look at Super Week, Millennium lost all the games. Been playing pretty sloppy, to be honest. Could also just be because they were happy sitting as like just a quarterfinal team, didn't want to aim towards the top two, and therefore didn't really prepare too much, and again, look forward to next week. I'm not too sure. Millennium looked very weird this week here, so...
Well, they're on a 0-3 right now.
If I had to choose, I would take Millennium at this point, also because I know how well Rocket can prepare for like quarterfinals or playoffs in general, like best out of five. So in that case, I would choose Millennium, but it's always impossible to say with Millennium because they play their own kind of style, very aggressive. You can get surprised if you play against them because if you do fall behind, they will just keep rolling, keep rolling, keep rolling, and all of a sudden you lost the game.
Well, Limp Bizkit would be proud of you.
I know.
What about the Copenhagen Wolves? Gambit, potentially a repeat of the start of Super Week, where Gambit, of course, won that game, the very first game, which is what's put them in this situation in the first place. Could be tied for seventh place. You know, obviously we saw SK Prime and NIP going at it. There's also the likes of H2K out there, Gamers 2, all in the Challenger Series. I mean, what? You've got to be in a better position with seventh. We heard Diamond saying, well, I don't really mind whether I face the likes of NIP, but you've got to be thinking, surely, you want seventh place. At least you want at least some choice.
Yeah, you just want a choice. Very, very important, so you don't feel like you just get stuck with whatever team everyone else doesn't want to face. And SK Prime yesterday looked very strong, to be honest. NIP on the other side,
well, honestly,
actually had a very weak
they
performance.
Technically went 3-0 if they didn't throw it so hard in that base where Ziz just sort of just hit the nexus.
That's what I mean. They were clearly the better team. And if H2K has some issues, I can imagine you guys upstairs yelling, hit the damn tower.
We were actually yelling pretty loud. I think we were yelling louder than the crowd maybe at that time. Super Hot Crew, though, in this game against the Copenhagen Wolves. What do we think? How are we this going to work? Because a Tristana versus a Kog'Maw, late game power spikes, both of them. Mid lane, Zigzari, actually probably fairly even, I would say, power spike wise.
But very different playstyle. In the case of Sylph, he needs to actually... He's going to build DFG, we've seen it before. He needs to just single out a target very fast in these teamfights. Otherwise, Soren should have the advantage. And also, Copenhagen Wolves can easily siege up a tower, wave clear for days, which is always a lovely thing about Ziggs, which is why we love to see him play it as well, because he can extend the game if Copenhagen Wolves do fall behind.
Big invade coming in the top lane here. Impaler looking to get around the back of Youngbook. There is no ward, no vision. Youngbook pushed very far up lane here. Broken Shard, meanwhile, doing the same in the mid lane. Cocoon totally missing on towards Selfie. Not going to thread the needle, but that was a good satchel charge. It will blow him backwards. Going to dodge out the side, but he will not dodge the basic attack. And it's Soren that picks himself up first blood.
All right, so very early first blood here. Youngbook opened his top lane. Had to use his flash, but he did survive. Mimer then pushing into lane. Selfie using both summoners at level 3 and always already forced back to base here. He's going to fall behind in XP, going to fall behind in farm. Definitely some issues for him.
And both flashes burned in that mid lane as well, remember. So we'll see whether the junglers decide to focus on that. Impaler has a choice, really, of where he wants to go in this game. You know, he didn't go back off. Ninja Tabby bought first item from Mimer on Shyvana.
Well, you do want some early armor against the Renekton, because Youngbok is looking to push up the lane, try and bully Mimer, and you don't want to get in a situation where you get too low on your own tower and the enemy jungler has walked up and it's an easy dive, especially because jungler Elise, go in, get the aggro, repel, and reset it.
And obviously with Tristana, we just saw it actually in action there. He's going to use that explosive shot, wants to fire it onto you every single time, but Kasing has the black shield, and that's just going to counter that every time he tries to fire it off, as well as, of course, the thresh hooks.
But just keep in mind, if he does use the black shield to block the damage from Tristana, it opens up now for Unlimited to go in, flay someone back, or land a hook if he can, and therefore set up the next amount of trading or harass coming in from Woolite. So at the moment in this bottom lane, it's definitely in favor of Woolite and Unlimited, and they have also been pushing up the lane. We could see Woolite go for static shift first item and just keep doing it, keep shoving it in, and trying to deny some CS from Mr. Royalis. For now, though, they are just sitting standard lanes, we saw the jungle ganks, 1-0 for Broken Shot in that case, over the British jungler in Paler.
Well, the British jungler is the one that's looking to try and make a play. He's backed off instead. Was looking to have a peek down this bottom lane. Mr. Rallet's happy to just farm up on the tower. His English support is working out well for him, keeping that CS going. So 45-50. We did see Warlight, of course, yesterday. Went with that, as you mentioned, the static shift early on in the game against Rocket, the one they did pick up. It is their only victory of the week. So sticking with what they know, sticking with what worked in that bottom lane pair.
But it's very, very important for Copenhagen Wolves they do win the laning phase, because they always want to go for the first dragon of the game, and then they want to go for next one and next one, and even if they are behind, they will keep going in and look for the fight, and it's one of the reasons they often, in the past, have just fallen so far behind early in the games and couldn't do anything to come back, because they keep picking these team fights. So as long as the laning phase goes well for them and they will be strong for the first or second dragon fight, they might be able to win it like they did yesterday against Rocket and then take the whole game.
Now it is Woolite continuing to keep that pressure down. Good explosive catch once again. Selfie avoiding this time. Will get away. That spirit rush enough to keep him safe at level 6. That's the big thing with Ahri. If your flash is down, it doesn't really matter, because you still have that ultimate to rely on to dash away.
But he just hit level 6 as Broken Shot came in here. Otherwise, he would have been stunned up again. Probably would have died again. Ulti is down, however, and up his top lane. Mimer looking to be aggressive.
Pouncing in. No ultimate coming out from Youngbuck. Didn't decide to use that Dominus. Instead, he will be safe. Unlimited. Is he going to throw any moves out here? No, doesn't look like it. Is he happy to just Black Shield up once again? And every time Warlight fires that off. Very passive bottom lane, actually. It's been the mid and the top that they're focusing on. The jungler's not really paying any attention, so I think they're just feeling comfortable in those two bottom lane pairings that they can deal with themselves. It may well be a blue invade, though, coming out, or will it be an early dragon?
But remember, Selfie has no flash and no ulti at this point here, so he can't really get into any fights. Impaler as well, wisely enough, goes back into his own jungle here. Just wanted to check if they could spot a Broken Shot, who's already level 6 at this point. And I like the fact Copenhagen Wolves put so much focus on the mid lane, because the forced early flash came in once again. If they could pick up a second kill, all of a sudden Selfie, the guy we just talked about, either goes 10-0 or 0-10, would have had a very bad start. All the other teams always talk about how he's a player who can go on tilt if he does get the bad start. So clearly the tactic from Copenhagen was to try and shut him down.
Blue buff being picked up. Sorin will get that one though. Pressure from Super Hot Crew. Death sentence lands on Mr. Rallet. Good rocket straight back on there. Tries to trade back, but honestly he didn't put as much damage down as that single explosive shot. It's quite annoying really. It's one of those passives that hits you and just slowly burns you down, damage over time that you just don't quite notice.
That's the worst. Zillion bomb as well.
Yeah.
Just waiting, okay, one
second. Well, you even get the timer on that one, you're just like, yeah.
Even worse. Mid lane, however, CS lead for Sorin. Also with the first button, Impaler will find himself a pink ward. Very, very passive start to the game, especially down this bottom lane. They're basically just pushing it in. The other team picks up the farm, push it back, and up in his top lane, Youngbuck is a flash again. So. Once again, jumping him.
Moment. It is Impaler looking to go in towards his top. Let's see if he can manage to land this successful gank up with the first one, Super Hard Crew. Broken Shard is nearby. I'm not sure Mimer's going to pounce on this one. He doesn't want to dive on through. And it does mean, of course, that he's safe. Broken Shard does come up to support him. And now Mimer to dash away from this one. Can't stick around too long. Impaler heading back up there to make this a 2-on-2. Look at Youngbuck, look how aggressive he's going. Impaler's just going to wait. Don't think he fancies a straight up brawl with Broken Shard in that tri brush. No, he's going to back off.
We have to remember Broken Shard actually went for Quill Code here. So not building AP early on, which will make him slightly weaker in these small ganks, these counter ganks. But in terms of team fights, because he's going to get the extra HP, he can act now as a second tank together with Youngbuck. It does mean, however, there's a lot of all the damage actually needs to come from Sorin and Woolite unless Broken Shard want to complete his Spirit of the Ancient Golem and then build some AP, which we have seen before, some magic penetration, sorry, which we have seen before, and then still do some damage. But early on here, less damage from Elise than we normally see, so a bit more tankiness.
Well, Static Shift was indeed completed by Woolite early on. We'll give him a bit of a push. I mean, as if Tristana's not going to push hard enough as it is in lane. That explosive shot. He's going to continue that one. Mimer trying to bait in Youngbuck a little bit here. Dominus waiting to try and pop that one out. Mimer could pounce across. Duke, of course, gives him some big bonus stats once he hits that Dragon Descent, while Impaler waits off at the side with Cataclysm. Flash still up for both these top laners. Going to be Mimer to step away.
So while the Wolves were putting their focus on the mid lane earlier, Impaler's been in this top lane here a few times because they want to make sure Mimer can either go even or get a lead over Jomborg, get his item build up, get some tankiness so Jomborg won't be able to bully him out of the laning phase and then simply outscale him. Because Shyvana in a late game teamfight brings so much both engage, but also because she becomes so tanky with her passive, where Renekton does get outscaled by pretty much every single top laner, which we see in the current meta.
Selfie being tracked by Copenhagen Wolves. Bomb bouncing through. Yeah, it gives him easy coverage that there's a ward in that bush. It's a simple 30 gold for Selfie. So, wave clear continuing between them. Slight advantage for Sorin. Top lane slide advantage. Good jump from Warlight there. Darkbinding was landing just as he rocket jumped in away. Does get, of course, some escape. Mimer finally going back. Oh, some fight came almost completed just as Jungbook's about to buck off. Got that triple door and start for him. Mimer's going to hold this on the tower though. Nearly messed up there. Warlight taken though, but again, there's so much escape for Warlight. The lantern, the rocket jump, he can get out of most situations they can throw at him.
I would love to see Copenhagen Wolves set up a dragon now. Mimer used the teleport in the top lane. Jomborg is running from base back to this top side, so they will have the advantage and can send down an extra man in case they start the dragon. And also because down this bottom lane, Warlight is always pushing it into the tower, getting some poke onto Mr. Rider, so it opens up for Copenhagen Wolves to push it, move to Dragon, teleport down if needed, and they are actually moving out all four members.
Yeah, Dragon's going to be started off by the Wolves, not really any reaction from the Super Crew, no teleport as you mentioned. This will be a simple first Dragon for the Wolves, gives them that gold advantage. Just that short of 2,000.
So very standard play from the Wolves, using the Renekton in the top lane to force out teleport from Mimer, and also one of the reasons Impaler use so much time in the top lane. If they could force Jomborg to use an early teleport, maybe Super Hawk Crew could have done what the Copenhagen Wolves just did here. Still, using the strong lanes we talked about to get the first dragon, to get an early goal lead. But we are taking it very slow here. Very easy.
It's a lot on the line for either team. Some playoff positions for Super Hawk Crew, relegation positions for the Copenhagen Wolves. Raid's been stolen away by Selfie.
That's risky.
Yeah, because Broken Shard's laying on the side. But again, Spirit Rush gets him out of the situation. Only just using the one. Didn't bother using it to get back into lane either. Jungbuck again escapes into top lane. Mimer goes aggressive, but Jungbuck happy to play this one quite passively. Is building in towards that Blade of the Rune King first. So wants to continue the aggression, despite the fact he's got to be that big tank. Whoa! Burst of damage on Sorin there from Selfie.
So I do like it if Copenhagen Wolves want to keep him split pushing and not look for big team fights. If they do, he's going to be very squishy for the first fights here. But it is their Jungbuck classic on Renekton up in his top lane. He loves to build Blade of the Rune King as the first item simply because your W counts as one hit effects and you can get 2-3 hits with it. And therefore you proc their 8% current health from Blade of the Rune King on every single one. And it's just very good burst from the start, which is the reason he loves to build it. But again, it does force him to stay as a split pusher for now. Broken Shard just fading out Ignite.
Try and draw it out, uses it. So Ignite goes down, Selfie not able to secure anything from that one, and Sorin bullies him out of lane. That means he's going to be pretty low on mana and health as this next wave continues to push. So Sorin continuing to try and drive some advantage. Pretty even in terms of CS because Selfie, of course, has been taking away those wraiths, which has kept him up just about. Not in terms of gold, though. That won't obviously give him the same amount of gold. Mimer has Jungbuck peeking out behind him, uses the Bilgewater Cutlass, actually, at the start of that fight, but Mimer was ill-affected, and of course with the Sunfire Cape, it's not really going to do a great deal.
Yeah, so right now Jomborg is actually weaker than Mimer. He needs to complete the blade before he can start dueling him, and on them it's taking a little bit of poke. AD carry-wise.
Oh, this is a risky fight for Warlight. He's only got the Static Shiv, whereas Mr. Rallis has just gone back to complete the Trinity Force. Really happy to have that duel, and Warlight, I think he took a bit more burst than he was planning there.
Still, though, notice how Warlight already has the BF sword as well. So we'll get Infinity Edge next time he backs, if they do time it correctly. Next dragon could be where he gets the gold he needs, go back to base, get his two items, which is the important part for Tristana, where she will now start scaling up into the late game. But Mr. Rallis, at this point, with Trinity Force, is very strong. And is also looking to just trade in there. We actually see Stuvaku for once push up the bot lane.
The problem is there is a ward, so if Impaler steps forward, He will get spotted, but Wallite himself could get drived on him. Impaler just waiting on the side. He's holding.
Broken Shard is here.
Time right now. He's going to go across. There's going to be jumping towards him. Broken Shard. He's holding the Cataclysm. Finally uses on Broken Shard. Unlimited now focus. Mr. Rylus gets him down. You can see on towards the third one. Can he get the triple kill? Wallite going to have to jump and flash away from this one. They're going to follow. Dark finding lands. In comes Impaler. It's going to be Mimer that gets the kill. And a three-man cleanup squad down the bottom. Gets all of the kills for Supa crew.
And the engage from Copenhagen Wolves completely failed here. There was Lantern for Broken Shard, the flash from Unlimited, but they didn't manage to lock down Mr. Alice. And instantly, Supa crew turned it around, teleport from Mimer. Also, just to secure the very last kill here. We'll lose the top tower, but got bot tower for it as well.
Yeah, one tower trade, but three kills. They're happy with that.
I'll take it.
Yeah, absolutely. So, backing off. Continues to be a build up, but check this. Good start. Very patient play from Impaler.
But notice how Broken Shard and Unlimited, there's nothing in this fight here. Flash Lantern in. Yes, there was a flay, but they missed the rise. He flashed, misses the hook, misses also the cocoon, and then Supa crew is in a perfect situation to turn it.
You know what? We said it was a good trade, but actually, I think I questioned why the teleport there. He came in, there was already a double kill before he even appeared on the teleport. That was already very much in their favor. It was only Wallite they got came in to pick up the kill. So he could have held that top turret.
So it could have been an even better trade for Supa crew, who's still in their favor because they picked up the kills. But yeah, you're actually right here. He should have stayed in this top lane, tried to defend. The tower, however, was already taking some damage from Youngberg because he's constantly pushing it down. And Selfie not really been using his ultis to deal a lot of damage in this game yet.
Use that spirit rush to great effect. Missed this guy around. Sauron just explosive satchel charging away and gets himself to safety. Mr. Rales once again got the support of his jungler, so I think he's feeling pretty safe down here. Currently 2-0-1 now. What's with those Berserker Greaves? There's no support nearby just yet. He's off. Going back to base. We'll see what Kassim goes with here. The dragon, of course, is up in 30 seconds, so everybody's kind of positioning themselves. No teleport for either top laner actually at the moment. That won't be available for this dragon, so we'll see whether they start making the moves. It looks like Mimer is heading down this way.
Yeah, so he's moving. Youngberg wants to just push out the lane here. I'm not sure if Copenhagen Wolves want to try and stall the dragon until his teleport is ready. Just about 20 seconds, or can actually see from the timer ticking down here. But still, it's not ready yet. Mimer is with Supa crew. Dragon is spawning just a few seconds. They can start it instantly, and Copenhagen Wolves will have to contest with only four people.
Looks like it will be clear down there.
Now he's moving.
Yep, now he's moving down. A little bit late on this one. It is, of course, a long timer on that teleport. So Dragon down to half. It's going to go. Impaler's got this one secured. And wisely, the Wolves do back out. They've made some tricky decisions on that before. This time, they fancy going for Kassing, and they throw a cocoon and a hook towards the Black Shield. And Kassing just walks away, no problem. Megrim Fenobot will go out. They're going to have to flash for it if they want it.
Well, let's see here. Going in, Broken Shard.
Oh, they got it.
Got him.
But they're going to lose Broken Shard now. They're going to lose a lot more, maybe. Mimer could come through. Selfie will come around the side there. Unlimited taken low. Sauron actually missed the charm on towards him. Now Youngberg comes around the side. Supa crew stepping away. Some pretty poor team play from both sides there.
But still, mid tower now for Copenhagen Wolves. They shouldn't have given up this dragon beforehand. It was sloppy play with teleport and with Youngberg up in his top lane. Just some missed timing or miscommunication from Copenhagen Wolves. Did, however, get a mid tower. Traded one for one as well. And it's very important they get down these other turrets if they do want to play more aggressive and want to get some wards in Supa crew's jungle. Which you now only miss the bottom lane one, which is not very important actually.
Sauron didn't care about that pick one clearly. He's going to keep on back. Selfie pushes back in. So mid tower did go down. It's the second one of the game for the Wolves. They will wipe out these wave and maybe how they're going to group up. Darkbinding not even remotely close to catching onto Sauron. And it means that they will back away. Top lane, that's going to get wiped out. Mimer will go up there. The question is, I think it's actually Wolves that may well be the aggressor now. They seem to be the one that's grouping. They have a gigantic wave that Youngberg is going to happily farm out down that bottom lane. So as we start to transition into the mid game, how do we rate this one? They're pretty even in gold. Who is coming out on top and who's going to be looking to be the aggressor?
So the fact that on a Woolite almost as in vintage completed and will actually be very strong, even from this point on, means Copenhagen Wolves have the ability to now siege up on towers because you have the long range from Tristana, you have the poke coming in from Soren on Ziggs as well, and you do have a Renekton who is very strong in his mid game here. So Copenhagen Wolves are definitely in a situation where they can start pushing down and force a tower, but they need to be careful because an Ahri can blow up people early, especially because DFG is almost completed for Selfie. And then we might see Super Hawkdraw on the other hand trying to flank around Copenhagen Wolves, land a charm and just blow up the first target. Because even Copenhagen, or even Youngbuck, who is supposed to be the tank, won't be able to survive if he gets caught by Selfie and one more member from Super Hawkdraw.
Well, Youngbuck's getting some good free time down that bottom lane. He's continuing to farm up. Mimer will stop him pushing on towards that tower, and it's given Woolite now a chance to move up to the top and clear three waves so far. But we do see Impaler waiting off the side there with Mr. Rales. They want to try and make a move. Look at this, Cassim coming up as well, but Mr. Rales, big trade for him. Woolite will come out on top though. Will come out on top, Unlimited. He's not going to get away. Flash Pancake comes out. Dart Binding will land, and Impaler gets himself the kill. Ooh, Mega Inferno Bomb will dodge down. Mr. Rales didn't step into that one as Selfie gave the warning.
So there was no Infinity Edge yet for Woolite, and yet he jumped in towards Mr. Rales, missed the jump, didn't get any damage from it, and then he started moving away as soon as he saw Impaler and just got hit from Mr. Rales constantly and ended up dying for it. Very, very aggressive play, but really backfired. There was no wards in the jungle of Super Hawkdraw to see if anyone from Super Hawkdraw was there to help Mr. Rales, and yet we just saw Woolite balls deep, jumping in on Tristana.
Jump straight across it, Dart Binding on Broken Shard, not gonna get followed through, but there's a wave coming in the mid lane and Super Hawkdraw are all moving towards it. They fancy that middle turret, but Mr. Rales isn't going to join them, then they're not going to get it, that's for sure.
For now, Broken Shard is only member to actually defend. He's only against support, so not exactly very hard. Now Selfie joins in, gets some damage, and Soren is back with a great wave clear. And Woolite, going back to this top lane here, probably not going to see him jump in again in the next few minutes.
Honestly, in terms of teamwork, I think Super Hawkdraw look disjointed to me. There's a number of times where there's been opportunities, like one member's trying to create them and then everybody else is not on the same wavelength, they just back away. Communications even isn't there, I'm not too sure, but they are leading. Nonetheless, individual skill is carrying them through. And of course, that great fight down the bottom lane where they just outnumbered them 4-on-3. Youngbuck got himself a little bit of time here, and Paler is going to defend this turret, which means it's an immediate sign I'm just going to back off. Let the minions just take a couple more chunks of hit points off of the tower. 1 minute 20 until that next dragon is up. Blue buff looking like it will be soon as the Copenhagen Wolves try to get their dominance in and around the mid lane.
But really also just to highlight the passive early game we saw from the laners, both junglers has been part of all the kills. So whenever they weren't ganking, nothing really happened in the lanes. They were just farming or maybe trading a little bit between each other. But as soon as the jungler showed up, we saw some kills. Impaled down this bottom lane, were part of all the kills on the Copenhagen Wolves. He was up there to help Mr. Rales in the one-on-one against Tristana. So he's just been everywhere on the map and been the guy to secure the kills from Super Hawkdraw. Didn't get any kills on Self yet, which is a bit different compared to what we normally see.
Soren caught out there, the charm and Dark Binding lands. Mr. Rales comes in, gets the last shot on Unlimited. That leaves them pretty short in the defense on this mid lane turret. You can see Selfie fancies it, can't get it quite close enough. Soren very, very low on hit points. Can't really fight this one, has to be very defensive there. I've got good wave clear from Woolite though, and again, there is that ultimate being used, but it's not enough to clear it.
So now Copenhagen Wolves falling further and further behind in terms of gold, so they might just have to rely on wave clearing with Soren and just sit back and wait now for Woolite to scale up and then take late game team fights, because they're gonna lose the next dragon as well, not in a position to fight. And the mid game clearly gone in favor of Super Hawkdraw. It's been all about first the gank in bottom lane, then the trade in top lane for Woolite, which opened up for a lot of kills on Mr. Rales. He's very strong at this point, almost completed Blade of the Ruined King. And also just Super Hawkdraw have been picking up the towers. Remember, they got the top tower earlier, also by Woolite died.
Well, it seems that Super Hawkdraw have their destiny in their hands, and right now it seems they will be getting that third place secured. The Copenhagen Wolves, can they claw themselves back into this game? It's a 5,000 gold differential between the two teams right now. 3-2 in turrets, the Super Hawkdraw with the advantage. DFG, as you mentioned, completed for Selfie. He's going to start looking for those big kills and will be able to start popping the likes of Sorin or Warlight if he gets onto them, and of course Unlimited if he's simply collateral damage gets in the way.
And with Impaler on Jarvan, with Mimer on Shyvana, there's a lot of options from Super Hard Crew to actually engage. Also because you have Binding, you have the Charm. Copenhagen Wolves always need to be careful when moving around here, because one skill shot onto them and Selfie will jump, pop his GFG, and either kill them or get them so low that Mr. Wireless can just walk in and give them one auto attack, like we just saw before here in the mid lane. But now though, it is actually Copenhagen Wolves pushing up this mid lane with all five members. Selfie was down in this bottom lane, will be joining in and going back again, waiting to see what Subaku wants to do, because Copenhagen Wolves at this point are just waiting for Subaku to make a move and then try and punish.
Nobody's really dealing with Selfie, who is once again pushing that bottom lane. Now we see Youngbuck going down there. Sorry, Warlight going down there. Of course, Mega Inferno Bomb's always available to wipe out the wave if required from the mid lane. Impaler is going to make a peek towards Youngbuck. They're going to have to tower dive, and there's a beefy Crocodile to tower dive. Already started off though, he is going to get caught out. Half his hit points already down. He hasn't even been able to pop that Dominus. Now instead, we'll just go down.
Keep in mind here, Youngbuck, he built the Spirit Visage as his first defensive item. If you ignore the boots here, you have the Blade doing physical damage to him, you have Jarvan doing physical damage, and the auto attacks from Mimer. So, with so little armor, it was very easy for Super Aku to just kill him here. And it's one of the issues when you do build Blade of the Rune King, you invest a lot of gold into damage, which does make you squishy. And Subaru killed now. Youngbuck and got a top tower, even though there was a Ziggs and a Tristana to actually wave clear. It doesn't matter if you just move to a different lane, kill whoever is defending, and take a tower.
I mean, I'm confused by that last fight. If you got your ultimate dominant, oh my god, Unlimited, you did. Is going to get caught out again. The Serala's happy to get the last hit. Now Broken Shard caught out. Ignite goes down. Sophie on towards him and the Super Hot Crew taking exactly what they want. I'm confused by Younger's play there. He used the flash, yet it's not his ultimate, which was available. Yet his ultimate is on a much shorter cooldown than that flash.
I'm not sure if he expected it. Oh, Sophie might
Selfie's
be in trouble.
He's dead. Warlight's going to get on towards him. That's a queen clean kill for him. But now Impaler slides in. That forces the rocket jump.
Okay, but up in his top lane here, I'm not too sure why he didn't use the ult. Maybe he figured it was too late in the end and just saved it.
But he used the flash. If you're gonna flash, may as well use your ultimate. I don't know. I'm confused by that little bit of play. Mr. Rallas, though, dominant performance from him so far. 5-0-2, everything being set up nicely for him.
Great last hit.
Micah Singh, and again, 1-0-7 for Impaler. You know, he's had some criticism from us, I think it's safe to say, over the current week, and has been a little bit lacking in his play, but today the Super Hot Crew have absolutely stepped up, and that is what they need to do with quarterfinals looming.
It is, and again, they don't want to get into this tiebreaker, they want to avoid it, so really showing here how good they can be. But also we do see from Copenhagen Wolves, they still seem to have a lot of issues where they come late for a dragon, or they get caught out of position, or they make this over-aggressive play, and they get punished. The gank in bottom lane, then the fight up in top lane, which was pretty much where Super Crew got the goal lead. And it's just been the story for Copenhagen Wolves. They want to make plays, they want to fight, don't want to just sit back and farm normally. And most teams in Europe know how to punish them.
The Copenhagen Wolves are grouped up. There's four members pushing down this mid lane. Selfie's off in the top. That Binding though, catching on Unlimited as he immediately gets some poke from Mr. Rallas. Off of the side, Mimer and Youngbuck are trading blows, just one for one. Not really a great deal happening between them. Impaler looking to flank around, trying to get some vision in and around that the jungle area. It's good vision actually from the Super Hot Crew. They have good notice, which is why Mimer knew Warlight was coming. Pink Ward will get cleared out though, which means he'll step away. Selfie still unchecked in that top lane, pushing in.
You just push it all the way to the tower here. The rest of your team is already pushing the other lanes. You just saw Tristana in the bottom lane. You see four members in his mid lane, so you can safely push it in and hope someone will go up to defend, and then Selfie can try and one-on-one them.
He's not taking a lot of damage there. Look at the position in Selfie. He's going to try and sneak around the side here. Sorin's low. He fancies it. It would be a big tower dive instead. He's just going to rotate back up towards the top. Warlight cleared the wave. He would continue the farm. as Mimer continues the pressure in the bottom lane.
They do need to place a ward in the base of Copenhagen Wolves so they can see Bullight moving between the mid lane and the top lane, and then Selfie can try and kill them. They did actually try and put a pink ward, was cleared however, so Selfie not really feeling. He has the ward control to stay between the two towers and then just kill whoever is moving to the top lane. For now, they just the entire jungle is owned by Super Hawk.
Mimer, Broken Shard going at it once again. Blade of the Rune King is available for Mimer if he needs it. Bunch's Veil has been popped. Dominus was used. Now they turn it around. He baits in Impaler to come around here. Youngbuck's in trouble. Broken Shard will join them, but he is too late. Megrim Phenobomb lands. Impaler very low. Impaler should be able to slide away. He has got Flash available if he requires it, and he does. Cocoon will not land. Now here comes Mr. Rales. Now you're in trouble, Copenhagen Wolves. They're going to have to slide away. Dark Binding. Oh, nice out from Sorin. Good dodge. But look at this. It's leaving Selfie all alone in the top lane to put all of the damage back onto the inhibitor turret.
Poor little Woolite, the only member left to actually defend. And Selfie does back away because the rest of Copenhagen Wolves is in base. But once again, Jombok fighting against Mimer. Impaler is the guy who joins in, turns it around. Tuboku picks up another kill, takes another dragon. And they could, at this point, just start baiting up Baron as well if they don't want to pressure the lanes and just wait for one binding or one charm from Selfie to land and then blow up whatever target is.
Honestly, I don't think they need to do that.
They don't need to, but
the
they can do it.
They're 12,000 gold ahead, and they are basically pulling Copenhagen Wolves from pillar to post. They don't know where to defend at what time. That top inhibitor turret's so exposed. You can see they've just pinged down on it, and they're like, yep, this is absolutely our target. We'll clear out all of the waves, which they've been doing very well so far, and just keep that pressure on. Youngbuck has already proven that he can sort of deal with Mimer, but he's already in that kind of losing period. Level 17 up against the Shyvana. Shyvana generally will come out on top. They're both fairly evenly built.
So let's see here. Impaler moved to the Baron. They're just waiting for Mr. Rales. Selfie getting some damage.
Yeah.
But they have the bottom lane pushing now. You might as well go straight to Baron. And if someone from Copenhagen Wolves goes back to defend it, even if it's Youngbuck, you can just pick up a target.
Unlimited dead. He's going to get taken down here. The question is a matter of who will get the final kill. It's going to be gifted to Impaler. Broken Shard caught out. Well, if your jungler's going to go down, he manages to get away. Repels across to the golems. That's only the support down. It's not the end of the world for the Wolves. They can still try and get in. Broken Shard only on half hit points, though, coming into this fight. And if he gets caught with one of those dark bindings from Kasing, will be curtains for him. Mimer's going to keep defensive duties, by far the strongest opponent. They're actually peeling away. They don't fancy the Baron. Instead, they're caught on Youngbuck. He's going to get in trouble. Charm lands. He's dead. He's going to go down. Now they're caught on. Mimer comes around the side. Broken Shard, Sorin, all very low. Everybody running for their lives. Woolite, the AD carry, in trouble. He's going to have to use his ultimate to blow them away. Gets a lifesteal back as Super Hot Crew once again go back to the Baron pit. This time, they will secure it.
Still, Broken Shard is alive. He does a flash. He can go in once again. There's no ping ward from Super Hawk Crew, so if they do manage to place a ward, there's only one sweeping lens and...
Well, he went for Broken Shard. Warlight caught the brunt of the damage, though. Broken Shard will go down. Selfie comes flashing through. Didn't expect that one, nor did Unlimited. That's for sure. Warlight's going to get on towards him, though. Will manage to get the kill, but not before the Baron is picked up by the Super Hawk Crew.
All right, so Baron and Super Hawk Crew, yes, they didn't need the Baron. It's just an easy way to get Copenhagen Wolves out of the base and pick up some more kills. And now they do have the Baron buff and can go back to what they did before. Mimer in one lane, Selfie in a different lane, and then Mr. Rales pushing up the mid lane. And at the moment, it's just a matter of time before Super Hawk Crew kills an inhibitor, gets super minions into the base of Copenhagen Wolves, and then the Wolves are forced to just pick a team fight. And if they do manage to win it, they can try and delay or try and make a comeback. Otherwise, Tsubaku should be able to pick it up and avoid the tiebreak.
Yeah, and this of course will mean that the Copenhagen Wolves will end at 8-20. The same as Gambit Gaming. And they will be playing off against Gambit Gaming in a tiebreaker that will follow the Millennium Alliance game. And that will be the only tiebreaker, thank goodness, this time around in the summer. Summer often brings some impressive tiebreakers. This time, it's not going to be one of those big five-team tiebreakers that we saw back in spring.
But it's going to be a great game because Gambit have looked so aggressive in the Super Week. So I'm really expecting Gambit to just come in, look constantly for fights. And we know Copenhagen Wolves, they're not shy to jump in as well. So we're going to get two aggressive teams against each other. And of course, it's going to be on stage here. So everyone in the crowd, stay. You're not allowed to leave.
Not allowed. It's going to be kept captive here. Selfie moves on through, motors up that lane, keeps the waves crashing against Copenhagen Wolves. The rest of his team rotating around, getting the vision of all of the jungle area. The Wolves completely held captive in their own base right now. They can't push out. They're going to try to start something off on Mimer once again. They will pop his Banshee's Veil, but that's about all they're going to do. It's a fight for Red Buff. That's what they're doing right now, fighting tooth and nail for anything they can get.
Subaku is just seeing wards, running around. Now they're actually pushing up, but they keep self in the mid lane now. And not really going towards the towers yet. You can even put Morgana and Selfie together and just land one of the CCs and kill whatever target it is to open up the base. For now, dude, still keep Selfie in the mid lane.
Well, Mr. Rallis just took down half the hit points without any response. Of course, he could just lifesteal his way back to full health along with the regeneration that he gets from that Baron. Meanwhile, top lane, you do see Selfie sneaking up there. Broken Shard, Youngbuck, sorry, and it's being aggressive to Mima. Now comes Selfie, comes around the side there. Charm does not land, but that tower gain is regenerating a little bit of health. But the bottom one, meanwhile, Mr. Rallis takes that one down as Woolite takes a quick orb from Selfie. They're pushing both top and bottom with ease, and there's not a lot that the Wolves can do to respond here. They split into which way they're going to defend it. They've got an exposed inhibitor now that Mr. Rallis is singly auto-attacking, and nobody's getting close to him.
No, and they're going to try to set up a fight here, but even if they do land some CC onto Super Hot Crew, I'm not sure they want to go in. They have to, otherwise they're going to lose the inhibitor, which is gone.
That's the inhibitor gone. Now we do see Mima pushing in with the minion wave. The rest of the team rotate towards it. Youngbuck still just off at the side, all in his own. That charm is available from Selfie if he wants to throw it out. That binding lands, charm will follow. Dominus comes out, not gonna happen. DFG blows him away. Selfie gets dropped in the meantime. Broken Shard, he's in trouble. Impaler doesn't quite get the kill on towards him, but Mr. Rallis does. He gets himself the double on Unlimited. Mega Inferno Bomb lands on three members of the Super Hot Crew. It's gonna force them back for now, but only in time for Mr. Rallis to follow the next wave in and continue the auto-attacks on the inhibitor turret.
And remember, the top tower is still pretty low. Woolite, though,
ooh,
not a kill, actually.
Got a pop there quickly. Woolite, there's still a danger, man. He's pretty tanky right now, could do a lot of damage. But that does force them away. So the Wolves live to fight another day. They're going to try and force the Super Hot Crew back and try and shove one of those waves down.
So blue buff and dragon now for Super Hot Crew. Can go back to base, use all the gold they picked up, and then move into towards the Copenhagen Wolves again here. And we really need to see an ace from the Wolves if they want to keep playing the game here. Woolite needs to just go huge, a Sorin, get a pentakill. No blue buff, of course. Just going to see the fight again. Once again, engage from Unlimited misses. Youngbuck is the first target. He blows up instantly. Selfie, however, he does actually die, which means now Super can remember they are tanking the tower during this fight. Woolite playing very aggressive once again. Until we actually do see a nice bomb from Sorin, does a lot of damage. We go back here. Woolite is the only guy left. Kasing is still very, very low. He wants to go in, land a binding. Woolite is like, nope, and you're dead.
Quick two shots. Very rapid fire on that Stana. So, Selfie going to wipe out the wave. Push on through the Wolves. They've shoved everything out they can from the base. They've done just about all is possible to hold on, keep the waves at bay, but Baron up in just over a minute's time. I don't think Super Hot Crew are going to worry too much about that. They didn't get the middle inhibitor down, by the way. All Selfie's going to get caught out. The Wolves going to try and fire down towards him. The question is, will he get away? The bombs will rattle through. Spirit Rush, is it enough? No, he gets onto Broken Shard. Broken Shard will get him down. Impaler's going to come around the side. He's got Mima with him. The rest of the team focusing through. It's Mr. Rallis that they need, and he's not quite in range right now. Four or five members of the Wolves pushing up towards him, coming around the side. They're still taking everything they can, and Impaler, now Mr. Rallis is there. He can turn this one around. Mega Inferno Bomb will land, but it's only really going to do an ample amount of damage. Meanwhile, Kasing is going to back away. Well, the Wolves, they tried something. Didn't work out for them. Look at the mid lane. You can see there's minions going to start crashing against that inhibitor. Super minions going into the base. The Wolves have to back off. They can't stick around. They've got to go defend their base.
Still, they did manage to get a kill, and now force Super Crew back and just wait for Baron here. So, open top for Broken Shard to maybe try and steal the Baron, or the Copenhagen Wolves surprising Super Crew around the Baron pit here. So, Kasing is running up by himself. bit weird that Supa crew is actually splitting up at this point. Instead of just staying 5, go up to the open inhibitor. You are so strong, take it, and then you can move to top lane or to the Baron. Instead, Selfie just went to this top lane all alone. Nice setup by Copenhagen Wolves to actually kill him.
Well, I mean, it basically screams at Supa crew. It just shows their super weak has been a torrid time. While they may well get a win here, they've proved before they can beat the lower teams. It's the top teams they struggle with, and as you just said, you know, the teamwork is not there. And coming into quarterfinals, that's a dangerous, dangerous time to be lacking in the teamwork, to not be on the same page.
Look here.
Everybody's stepping away, and suddenly it's like, we're going to start the Baron. Wait, no, actually, we're not going to start the Baron because we're going to back away. We're not sure.
And they don't have a pink ward.
Questioning, yeah, they don't have a pink ward. They just don't have anything because, well, Kasing's gone for Iliandris.
He had a lot of time to go back to base, get a pink ward here, instead of running up towards the base and trying to land a binding on Woolite. If Bronjak can steal this one, it made. Maybe gonna buy something for Copenhagen Wolves. He's gonna go in for it. A lot of damage from Soren here.
A lot of damage. Mega Inferno bomb.
Oh, that's a bit too early.
Well, the Wolves go in. They may be able to finish it themselves. Can they smite it? They got it. Would you believe it? Now Supa Hot Crew. They can try and turn this one around. The Wolves gonna run away. Selfie goes in pretty deep. Mimer's been caught out. He's going towards Woolite. Woolite will not take him down. Now we're gonna see Mr. Rales cleaning up. He gets one, gets two. They push on towards Unlimited. Impaler's got his ultimate available. He can flag and drag and dumpster straight on his head. He's got no flash to get out of it. Unlimited's in trouble. He's gonna go down. Mr. Rales gets himself the triple as they push on through and probably will take the game.
So a bit of a sloppy ending from Supa crew, but they were so far ahead here. As soon as Copenhagen Wolves tried to fight for the Baron, Supa crew were the stronger team and now pushing into the base.
Oh, Mr. Rales, 11-0-4, big strong performance. Honestly, all he's been doing is pretty much last hitting, though, because the rest of the team doing work. They will take down the two Nexus turrets, and the Supa Hot Crew will finish third in the standings. That means they will be facing Rocket, and the Wolves, they have to face Gambit.
And a very, very important tiebreaker. Who gets to be number 8, and who gets to be number 7, and choose what challenger team they want to face in the promotion tournament. But still though, the start was actually okay for Copenhagen Wolves again, like we see in most of the games. The laning phase was fine. Yumbuck did well in the top lane, even though we had Impaler constantly ganking him in the top lane. Brogjar got the first blood in mid lane, got the first dragon. But in the second dragon, for some reason Supa crew were allowed to just run down 5 members and take it. Even though Copenhagen Wolves had the timer and everything, they didn't contest it, they weren't in a position to do it. And then we had the bot lane gank, and all of a sudden Supa crew were hitting gold and just used it to control the game.
Well, honestly, I do feel while it was a win for Supa crew, they've gone 2-2 this week, that may well just be papering over the cracks, because there seems to be some very big cracks in the teamwork of that team. Of course, you can only beat what's in front of you. The Copenhagen Wolves themselves made some questionable decisions once again, but a good performance from that man on your screens. 3-0-14 for Impaler. Solid, yeah. Solid performance in his final game before the quarterfinals.
And remember, in the start of the game, he was part of every single kill. Mm. It was him always there at the right place at the right time, making sure Supa crew always were stronger. So yes, a good performance by Impaler. We often talk about his performance, especially on a champion like Jarvan, can be very up and down, we should say. But this time it was good.
One thing I would say is he's had very good stats when off of Rengar.
True, like pretty much every jungler in the West.
Yes, pretty much every jungler over here. So it's a win. It does mean, of course, we can check out those standings for you guys. It does mean that, of course, the playoff bracket is now locked up as the Supa Hot Crew have taken third place. You can see right there on your screen, the Supa Hot Crew are going to be facing off against the Rocket. That will be happening on Thursday, August the 7th. And of course, the winner of that will face Fnatic in the semi-finals. That will be happening at Gamescom. SK Gaming will play Millennium. A juicy, juicy match for sure, that one. That's going to be happening on Friday, August the 8th. And of course, the winner will face Alliance also at Gamescom. All of those matches are best of 5 as well. Yep. We're going to go over to the main stage now. We have Shock standing by with Mr. Rales.
Thank you very much, D-Man. 11-0-4 on Kog'Maw in that game. Fantastic performance. Seems like it was pretty straightforward. The only moment it might have gotten scary was the Baron. Talk us through the late game for you guys.
The late game, we pretty much just had to go 1-1-3, where we'll go free in bot lane, and then RA mid, and he'll just rotate around, and he'll just take turrets. And yeah, the Baron was pretty much free, but yeah, sadly, he stole it.
You did throw it right from under your nose. Talk me about Super Week from your perspective. I asked Pimpaler before because, of course, you came into this day being 0-2, but being able to straighten it out and getting that third place.
Yeah, I think the Super Week was pretty bad for us. The first two games we played with, without even being in the game, like we didn't even do anything for both games, and we were just waiting for them to finish. But we managed to pick it up for these two games today, and I'm really happy to get third place, yeah.
So that does mean with that third place locked in that you will be facing Rocket first in a quarterfinal and possibly Fnatic over in the semifinal. How happy are you that you, or sad are you that you ended up with Rocket in the end?
I'm fine with Rocket. It doesn't really matter who we are playing against in playoffs because we have to win against them anyway to get to Worlds. So I didn't really care who I'm going to play against.
So how high do you think the chances are for the Super Hot Crew to make it to Worlds?
Well, obviously the chance is there. We will try our hardest to achieve it, but I don't know how big of a chance we have. We'll just try our hardest.
All right, well, thank you very much. Congratulations.
No problem.
All right, we're going to take a quick break, but when we come back, it is Alliance versus Millennium. We're going to stock up on buffs, and we'll be back in 3.5.
Broken Shot, the Limited now focused. Mr. Rylas gets him down. Charm is available for Selfie. He wants to throw it out. Dark Binding lands. Charm will follow. Dominus comes out. Not going to happen. DFG blows him away. The wall's going to run away. Selfie goes in pretty deep. Mime has been caught out. He's going towards Wallet. Wallet will not take him down. Now we're going to see Mr. Rylas cleaning up. He gets one, gets two.